Because of your giving, Nazarene Missions is a movement of God through the people of God. This movement is funded through the generous, sacrificial giving of people and churches throughout the world. World evangelism giving is the foundation for discovering, developing, and resourcing our missions organization and has enabled the Church of the Nazarene to spread the good news of Jesus Christ to unreached people and places. It is the cornerstone of our denomination's missional funding, with the largest portion of giving going to missions work in the Nazarene regions. These funds enable the regions to effectively implement church planting and discipleship strategies through local churches and ministries. Every church and individual in our denomination participates with their financial contributions to world evangelism, binding us together with a unified purpose and vision. Because of your giving, the Church of the Nazarene is able to develop and sustain worldwide communication, technology support, and new mission programs. All Nazarene missionaries, regardless of deployment status, benefit from the Missions Foundation created by World Evangelism Giving. Each missionary receives support, such as funding, insurance, and missionary care. Nazarene Missions International, Nazarene Youth International, Work and Witness, Global Missions, and many other ministries are supported by World Evangelism Giving. Independently funded ministries like Nazarene Compassionate Ministries, Jesus Film Harvest Partners, and World Mission Broadcast also benefit from the infrastructure it sustains. Through your giving, new churches worldwide are able to make an impact in their community. Those funds also train and equip pastors and church leaders in these churches. Pastors like Rafi, who fulfilled his call to ministry after escaping war-torn Syria. Today, Rafi and his mother Lena have started two Arabic-speaking churches in Poland. Your giving funds clergy development and ordination in the Church of the Nazarene and makes holiness education available worldwide through Nazarene institutions of higher education. Your giving provides resources and literature in more than 90 languages to churches all over the world. This includes resources for pastors and Bible-based teaching materials for children, youth, and adults. Because of your giving, schools like the Armstrong Primary School in Côte d'Ivoire are impacting their community. School children are being taught Christian values, and the students and their families are being reached for the Lord. In Mark 12, we see the beautiful example of a widow giving abundantly. Jesus calls his disciples and points her out as the one who gave the most, because she gave all. Our focus is not on how much we give. We give because we believe in a missional God who is at work through our Nazarene missionaries, reaching places and people we can't even imagine. We believe in a God who moves. And that belief, deeply seated in our hearts, moves us to give. We are a global church, a generous church, participating in the transformational love of Jesus Christ in our local communities. Together, through our world evangelism giving, we share Christ's love with the world.
Welcome to the Beacon Light Church of the Nazarene Family Worship Center.
My future and my life is worth a living door because he lives. God sent his son. To buy grave, but greater still. But greater still. Hallelujah. Oh, the calm assurance. Oh, this child I can face uncertain death because God lives. Does somebody have a testimony this morning?
All faith.
He holds my future. So my life is worth a living just because He lives. Hallelujah. 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 I don't know if you understand the significance of this song. It says, my life, our life, your life, my life. It doesn't belong to us, but it's worth a living just. Our children's life, our husband's life, it's worth a living just this morning because He lives. Church, let me see you stand, everybody. Let me see you stand and worship the Lord. Our life is worth a living just this morning because He lives. Because He lives. Because He lives. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah! Because He lives, I can face tomorrow. Because He lives, all fear.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah, church. Oh, come on, somebody, open your mouth and bless the Lord. Open your mouth and bless the Lord. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. He is not here. He has risen. Remember how He told you while He was still with you in Galilee. The Son of Man must be delivered over to the hands of sinners, be crucified, and on the third day be raised again. Hallelujah. Oh, come on, somebody get excited. Our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ is alive. Our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ is alive. Oh, hallelujah. And because He is alive, your life, my life, our lives are worth living. Glory to God. I don't know about you this morning. I don't know about you. I don't know what you come to do, but I come, glory to God, to magnify the Lord. Hallelujah. I come to worship Him. I come to praise Him. Hallelujah. Oh, God, I don't know about you. I don't know about you. I know every church has its own culture. I know Beacon Light, we have a culture. Hallelujah. But my prayer this morning is that God will move just like Himself. Yeah.
Hallelujah. Woo. Oh, we bless the Lord.
Oh, God, I want God to move like Himself. I don't know about you, but I want God to touch somebody this morning. I want God to bring transformation this morning. I'm believing God this morning that healing, physical healing, will take place. Come, somebody. I'm believing God that emotional healing will take place. I'm believing God this morning that deliverance will come. I'm believing God that, we're going to see a move of our glory to God this morning. As our faces are different, so are our needs. Glory to God. And hallelujah. Even as that prayer meeting this morning, the thought came that those women on resurrection morning, they went for one purpose. And that purpose was to anoint the body of Jesus Christ. But when they got there, something else happened. He was not there, but he was alive. And so I'm saying this morning, I don't know what you came for. I don't know why you are here today. But I am believing God that even today, hallelujah, that whatever we come for today, that we will get something else. Somebody may come to spectate, but that the anointing of God will be so rich. Somebody may here today because glory to God, is customary. But I'm asking church, is the one will chase a thousand, two will put 10,000 to flight. And so I'm believing, I want somebody to believe with me that God will show up and God will show off, that somebody will get a touch today. Somebody will be delivered today. Oh, glory to God. Glory to God. Come on, somebody. Glory to God in the highest. Move like yourself today. Move like yourself today, God. We want, God, to see an outpouring of your Holy Spirit today. Oh, hallelujah. We need an outpouring of your Holy Spirit today. We need that you will come and you will saturate this place with your anointing touch, oh God. Hey, glory to God. I'm sorry. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Von and come. Yes. Epilos, come. Oh, glory to God. I need Jesus to show up and show off. Oh, hallelujah. I just want to pray for you. Oh, glory to God. 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 Come on, somebody reach out and touch him. Hallelujah. Emotion. Hallelujah. I don't know. somebody worship God. Come on, somebody worship God. Because he lives. Because he lives. Because he lives. Because he lives. Oh, come on, somebody. Because he lives. Come on, somebody. Oh, hallelujah. Free up yourself today. Free up yourself today. It's Resurrection Sunday. Free up yourself today. Hallelujah. Glory.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We bless the Lord. Yes. Oh, we bless your name, oh God. Hallelujah. 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 We bless the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah, he's risen indeed. Hallelujah, can somebody just say hallelujah? Hallelujah, he's risen indeed. Hallelujah, hallelujah, he's risen indeed. And your response is hallelujah. We're gonna try it again. He's risen indeed. He's risen indeed. He's risen indeed. Hallelujah, hallelujah. It's Resurrection Sunday. We're just going to rejoice in the house and we're going to give God thanks and praise. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, church. Hallelujah. Aren't you glad that he's risen? Yes. Hallelujah. 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 Come on, just put your hands together. Celebrate.
Celebrate,
Come on, we're here to celebrate the King.
Celebrate Jesus.
Come on, just throw your hands in the air and say, he is risen. He is risen. Testify, say Jesus. Jesus is my deliverer. He is my deliverer. He is. He died on the cross and he delivered us from our sins. Tell me how. How do you know he delivered? Oh, how do you know he delivered me? Hallelujah. He delivered. Witnesses in the house. Hallelujah. me? He delivered me. How do you know he delivered? Thank God, the blood. One more time, the blood. The blood. Just as the blood. Thank God, the blood. Thank God, thank God. Thank you, Lord. Can we just lift our hands and say, God, thank you for dying on the cross for me. One more time, come on, all over this room, lift your hands and say, thank God for the cleansing blood. Thank God for the cleansing blood. Thank God for the cleansing blood that washes white. Can we just lift our voice and say, thank God, thank God for the cleansing. Thank you, Lord. You shed cleansing. Thank you, Lord. But you're no longer in the grave, you're risen indeed. That washes white as. Thank you, Lord. Can somebody just say, God, I thank you. I thank you. Hallelujah. 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 We were messed up in sin, but he delivers us. Hallelujah. Because he shed his blood on Calvary, but he's no longer in the grave, but he's risen indeed. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Can somebody just testify in the house that, God, I thank you for dying on the cross, but I thank you that Sunday came and you're risen indeed. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Can we just give God a wave in the house, God? Just be grateful people. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Lord, we thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. We can only encourage you to give God thanks, but you need to give him thanks for yourself. Just say, God, I bless you. God, you didn't have to do it for me, but I'm forever grateful. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 One songwriter says, he is Lord. He is Lord. Hallelujah.
Risen from the dead, and he and all over this. He is the Lord, and He is the Lord. Oh, and He is the Lord. He is risen, and He has risen from the dead. He is the Lord.
You are is what you're singing. Come on and say
hallelujah.
We encourage you, God, to give him what he's due this morning.
Yeah.
just declare all over this room, you are.
You are the risen King.
Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Just say thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. As we draw near for our family altar on this Easter Sunday, we just want God just to cover us, continue to cover us with his blood. If you feel the need to draw near, whatever situation, whatever issues you have, if you just come and just say, God, I thank you for dying on the cross, and I thank you for raising. Thank you for having that plan of salvation that you raised. You have risen from the dead. And I'm just going to ask someone to take the mic to Sister Luby as she does praise and cover us. So we just draw near for our family altar this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Our God is risen. He is
Oh, Father, who art in heaven, God, we want to thank you for your love. God, we want to thank you for your mercy. God, you paid a debt for us. We could not have paid. We accumulated so many debts, dear God, and we couldn't pay that debt. But we're glad you went to Calvary and you died for us. We're also glad this morning that you're no longer in the grave. You're no longer in the tomb, but that you're Father of your right hand making intercession for us. I just want to thank you. We want to thank you, God, because you are alive. You're not dead, dear God. And you can help us, dear God. When we talk about you. When we move around with you. So, God, be with us, dear God. Continue to tabernacle with us, dear God, as a church and as a people. God, we bless your name this morning. God, your name is worthy to be praised. Your name is higher than any other name. When it comes to the name of Jesus, there's power in the name of Jesus. Everything you want to find, it is the name of Jesus. You throw a lot of ingredients in, and the pot doesn't taste right till. But when we think about Jesus, we think about the highest beam. God, we bless you. God, we praise you. God, we adore you. God, we honor you. God, you wake us up this morning, and you set us on our way. And that's enough to give you praise. God, we are breathing your breath. No other man can breathe. When this body dead, they cannot put life back into this body. But we are glad for the man Christ Jesus, the highest beam, who can put life back into this body. Help us as a church, Lord, to be true and to be faithful and know we are where our destination will be. Because it's two destinations. It's either heaven or hell. Help us, dear God, to make this day today, Resurrection Day, our calling and our election sure and know we are going. Because the songwriter puts it, coming soon, not just as Savior, but as reigning King. And we're glad that when he comes, he's gonna bind the power of our Satan, for he is coming soon. Satan will no longer to rule and touch this body because Jesus will be here. So let us be true. Those who came in this morning, dear God, to see and for curiosity, God, turn it around. Let them put their life in shape, realizing that you're coming and they gotta be caught up to go with you. So we pray, dear God, as they enter this house this morning, the Holy Spirit will tabernacle with them. The Holy Spirit will wrap around them. The Holy Spirit will not let them go. But the Holy Spirit will pour in the oil and the wine and kindle the fire, dear God, so that not only they alone, when they get home, their household can come to know you. So God, bless us this morning. God, be with us this morning. God, we pray for your preached word, that as your word go forth, dear God, that it may cut some's heart asunder, it may lodge somewhere in the heart, that they can come to know someone who is here, can come to know Christ. And we who are with Christ, God, we can move up higher and leave the things that are not Christ-like behind. We are behind, realizing, dear God, that you're coming for people who are prepared and people who are ready. So God, continue to be with us. Continue to surround us. Continue to protect us. Continue to dine with us this morning, because we'll be sitting at your table this morning and we'll be feasting on your word. God, we bless you. We love you. We worship and we adore you. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Hallelujah. And all God's people say amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You may have your seats. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Can we just bless the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords one more time? He's good. Hallelujah. And when we have our family altar opportunities, don't take them lightly. As a family, we just want to pray for different issues as we come before Heavenly Father, because we know if anyone can work on our case, it's Jesus, our risen Savior and our Lord. And if on this Resurrection Sunday that there's anyone who just wants to give God thanks and praise, you have an opportunity now just to stand and give God praise. Is there any such person in the house? If there isn't, we won't prolong, but I'm just going to invite our pastor to come at this time to conduct a very important ritual in the circle of the Church of the Nazarene, our reception of new members. Can you welcome Pastor as he comes? Hallelujah, we bless the Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah, church. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. I want to testify this morning. That's all right, because you were given an opportunity to grab it. So I'm grabbing this opportunity. Oh, glory to God! Hey, you know, I don't know your story, and you don't know mine. When you see people come to church and they sit down, you don't know what's going on inside of them, so you can't tell them that they are not experiencing God. And when you see them running, shouting, you don't know what's going on. Glory to God, hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. I'm just testifying this morning. 21 years ago, the 28th of March, I was on duty at the St. John's Fire Station, and there was a fire call at 2 o'clock in the morning, and I was the driver of one of the trucks. Hey, glory to God. And while I was en route to the fire scene, I came in contact with another vehicle. The fire truck, the wheel, the truck was so high that when I stand up, I could actually go under the wheel bay. That's how tall the truck was. And the truck overturned, somersault. That's what I saw in the report. And I was thrown from the truck. I'm just telling you the story like you don't know. My number two lumbar spine, don't you know, was crushed. Not fractured, but crushed. But the tissue, my bones splint. There were splinters all about in the back. Okay. Oh, hallelujah. 4 of us were in the truck and were taken to the hospital. And while they were looking at the others, I heard the doctor said, "Hey, leave those. Those are all right. We are losing this one." At the end of the day, when they did all that they could have done, they said, "Mr. Delpesh, you will not walk again." Oh God, we're going. We have to go, but I don't know about you. You will not walk again. While they were doing their test, I'm saying, "Doc, I'm feeling." They said, "No, you're not feeling, because the test is showing you should not be feeling." Say, "However, we're going to stabilize your back." And say, they did an operation. I was going to say they bust my back, but it looked like that in a songwriting a church. But they opened my back and put about I don't know how long the steel was, rod in my back to stabilize me. The steel rod broke in my back. The sharp edge. I was walking. I remember one Thursday I saw the doctor, and the doctor said, "You need to come see me." I went by the next day, and by the Tuesday he said, "Boy, look, this steel breaking in your back. Oh, glory to God." And by Tuesday, he had to take it out. 21 years ago. Look what the Lord has done. And so I'm just testifying. I'm just testifying. I'm just testifying. Debosha, from losing this one, and this one would not walk again. Look what the Lord. Hey, look what the Lord has done. And so, on this Resurrection Sunday, you do your do. I'm going to do my do. I'm going to say, "Thank you, Lord." Yes, hallelujah. Glory, 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 glory. Kebosa, kebosha. I don't know why God did it for me, Chief. But I am eternally grateful. A few years after, I went into the doctor's office, and the doctor said, "George, I do not understand life." The doctor said that to me. Because he said, "A young lady came in to me a few days ago with her injury was mild compared to yours, and she's paralyzed. She can't move. He said, "Church, just give me a break, Jack. Just leave me alone. Because you don't understand. When you lie down on a bed for about 3 months, can't move, that your bed become your bathroom, your living room, your dining room, your everything. And then God give you another opportunity to walk again. Yes. And so, for the rest of my life, I'm going to spend it talking about the goodness of God. Because God has been good. And if you think that God is not in the miracle working business, look at me. Just look at me. I'm a living miracle that God still works miracles. Woo. And so I just had to get that out, because it's the 28th of March past and it's 21 years. And I know my brother has a testimony to that. It was just 1 year ago, not your brother Parker, just 1 year ago. And the Lord has touched. Amen. Amen. Oh, come on, somebody, open your mouth, give God a praise and thank him for his goodness. Oh, Lord of mercy. Yes! Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God. Somebody might be saying it doesn't take all that. May not take all that for you. But this is only my reasonable service. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Woo. Hallelujah. 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 Just let's sing that song again. Hallelujah. He's won the victory or something like that. So we go. Just sing it for one last time. Church, I want to invite every single person in this house, once you can, just stand to your feet. And let's just give God some praise in the house. Hey, whoa. To open your mouth just for just 1 minute, no music, no nothing, just open your mouth and thank God for who he is and for what he has done for you. Just 1 minute. Hallelujah. Just thank God. Open your mouth and just thank God. Hallelujah. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We praise you. We glorify you. We honor you, Lord. Your word, your word. You may have your seats.
Praise the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah. Want to invite Sister Normally Philip. Brother Vivian Parker. Not unto me. I'm the good looking one here. Brother Tommy and Sister Junie Hamlet. Brother Tish and Sister Norissa Smith. This is an important and a sacred moment in the church. After Pentecost, the Holy Spirit came in the first church there in the book of Acts. The Bible talks about how persons were added to the church daily. And what a great experience it would be if we can add people to the church on a weekly basis. And so this is a wonderful opportunity for us as a church to be receiving these persons into fellowship here at the Beacon Light Church of the Nazarene Family Worship Center. Dearly beloved, the privileges and blessings that we have in community together in the Church of Jesus Christ are sacred and precious. There is in it such hallowed fellowship, care and counsel as cannot otherwise be known apart from the family of God. There is the godly care of pastors with the teaching of the word and inspiration of corporate worship. And there is cooperation in service accomplishing that which cannot otherwise be done. Today, we affirm again a great statement belief for the Church of the Nazarene. We believe in one God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We believe the Old and New Testament scriptures given by plenary inspiration contain all truth necessary to faith and Christian living. We believe human beings are born with a fallen nature and therefore inclined to evil, and that continually. We believe the final impenitent are hopeless and eternally lost. We believe the atonement through Jesus Christ is for the whole human race, and that whosoever repents and believes in the name of Jesus Christ is justified and regenerated and saved from the dominion of sin. We believe that believers are to be sanctified wholly subsequent to regeneration through faith in Jesus Christ. We believe the Holy Spirit bears witness to the new birth and also to the entire sanctification of believers. And we believe our Lord will return, the dead will be raised, and the final judgment will take place. Those of you who are here for reception, do you heartily believe these truths? If so, answer individually, I do. Do you acknowledge Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior? And do you believe that he saves you now? If so, answer, I do by faith. Desiring to unite with the Church of the Nazarene, do you commit to love the Lord your God with all your heart, soul, mind, and strength, and your neighbor as yourself, as expressed by the covenant of Christian character and conduct? Do you commit to the mission of the Church of God as expressed in the doctrine, fellowship, and work of the Church of the Nazarene? Will you support the teachings of the Church of the Nazarene and strive with God's help to grow in your understanding and patience of the same in a way that enhances the witness of the church? Will you endeavor in every way to glorify God by humble walk, godly conversation, and holy service, by devotedly giving of your resources, and by faithfully participating in the means of grace? Will you follow Jesus Christ all the days of your life, abstain from all evil, and seek earnestly to perfect holiness of heart and life in the fear of the Lord? If so, answer, I will. I welcome you into the Church of the Nazarene and the fellowship of this local congregation with its benefits and responsibilities. May the great head of the church bless and keep you and enable you to be faithful in all good works, that your life witness may be effective in care for the poor and the oppressed and in leading others to Christ. Welcome to the Beacon Light Church of the Nazarene Family Worship Center. I welcome you into the Church of the Nazarene and the fellowship of the local congregation with its benefits and responsibilities. May the great head of the church bless and keep you and enable you to be faithful in all good works, that your life and witness may be effective in the care for the poor and oppressed and in leading others to Christ. Welcome. Brother Vivian.
Yes.
Good man. That's interesting. Monday morning, now me have to say yes, sir. Until you know, you say yes, sir.
Yes, sir. That's correct.
Brother Vivian, I welcome you into the Church of the Nazarene and the fellowship of the local congregation with its benefits and responsibilities. May the great head of the church bless and keep you and enable you to be faithful in all good works, that your life and witness may be effective in care for the poor and oppressed and in leading others to Christ. Welcome to the Beacon Light Church of the Nazarene Family Worship Center. Mr. Normally, I welcome you into the Church of the Nazarene and the fellowship of this local congregation with its benefits and responsibilities. May the great head of the church bless and keep you and enable you to be faithful in all good works, that your life and witness may be effective in the care for the poor and the oppressed and in leading others to Christ. Welcome to the Beacon Light Church of the Nazarene Family Worship Center.
Thank you.
Sister Narissa, I welcome you to the Church of the Nazarene and the fellowship of the local congregation with its benefits and responsibilities. May the great head of the church bless and keep you and enable you to be faithful in all good works, that your life and witness may be effective in care for the poor and oppressed and in leading others to Christ. Welcome, sis, to the Beacon Light Church of the Nazarene Family Worship Center. Brother Tish, I welcome you into the Beacon Light, into the Church of the Nazarene and the fellowship of this local congregation with its benefits and responsibilities. May the great head of the church bless and keep you and enable you to be faithful in all good works, that your life and witness may be effective in care for the poor and oppressed and in leading others to Christ. Welcome to the Beacon Light Church of the Nazarene Family Worship Center. Brother Clovis, I want you to pray. Come. I want to pray a special prayer for our new.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. As we welcome them, I just want to ask you to stand with me. Would you stand? Would you just stretch your hands towards these? Some of them, those who were not baptized, entered into baptism a couple of weeks ago, and some of us were there to witness, and so it's almost a natural next step. But how many of you know it's not going to be easy? It's not an easy road. Just stretch your hands towards them, if you will, as we pray. Almighty God, we thank you for grace and mercy and love that has seen us to this day. Lord God, as we welcome these six into the membership of the Beacon Light Church, membership of the Church of the Nazarene, a worldwide denomination, as we welcome them, Lord, Father, I pray that those whose hands are outstretched will truly, Lord God, be their keepers. You've said to us that the whole law concerning human relations, Paul said it in Galatians 5 and 14, I think. The whole law of human relations is in this one precept, that we should love your neighbor as you love yourself. Almighty God, may we love them. May our love, Lord God, reach them, touch them, change them. Lord God, may we take them into our homes and into our hearts as friends, Lord God. Paul has asked, he has admonished us to especially look out and to be good towards those of the household of faith. These are our new brothers and sisters within the household of faith. And we have been reaching out to some of them already, but I want us to make a special effort. Will we do that? Will we do that? Will we do that? Hallelujah. Father, thank you again. Thank you for their faithfulness. Thank you, Lord God, that even as we have been going through, Lord God, not the best of times, you have seen it fit to send the increase. Oh, Father, as we look around our communities and we look around our nation, Lord God, we know all kinds of stuff is happening. Father, I pray that you will send more. Lord God, I'm reminded of the bowl with names and the oil there, Lord God, even now in the name of Jesus, will you begin to do a new move? Will you agitate, Lord God, those who are in there, whose names are in there, Lord? Will you hasten, Lord God, their steps so that they would come and say, I want to be saved. I want to be baptized. I want to become a member. Oh, Lord God, will you bless them? Will you cover their families? Will you cover their families? Will you bless each one, Lord God? Will you, as it were, as you've promised, put your seal on them, even as we declare today that they're yours. They're yours. They're yours first. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Lord God. Would you put your hands together and give God thanks? Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name.
Thank you. Amen. Amen. Yes, and you may have your seats. I want you just now to turn around those. And so these are our new members. They're added to the family. And so I'm going to call the church board, those of you, the church board, to come. And I wanted to greet them. Reverend Luby, I wanted to join as well and just come and just greet them and make them feel welcome into the Church of the Nazarene. And others, you feel free, you can come and make them feel welcome. You feel free, you know, we want you to come and make them feel welcome to the Beacon. They have already felt it, but we just wanted to officially welcome them.
That's right.
You have rights. Amen. 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 Congregation, put your hands together for them, please. God bless you. You may have your seats. God bless you. So you have all rights and privileges. Right here, somebody done start to tell the pastor to charge a member of the church for one ply of paper towel. So I had to remind them that that person have all rights and privileges to how many plies they want. Amen. Blessed be the name of Jesus. And so there are still others. I know we baptized about, what, eight or so, and I think might be only one or so we see, but so the others, we, Sister Alicia still having, Sister Alicia wave, Sister Alicia still having converts class, and so if the Lord has saved you from your sins and you want to join our converts class, see Sister Alicia, if you're here today and you know the Lord has saved you from your sins, you want to be baptized, you can have a conversation with me. You have been coming to the church for a long time and you are not a member yet and you want to join us. You know, membership have privileges, isn't that true? Membership have privileges, glory to God, and you want to join us, you want to be part and parcel of the Beacon Light Church of the Nazarene, and you want to not only the 100 and how many of us here, but you are now part of a global church. I think it's 162 162 countries with some over 2.5 million members. And so you, after today, that number has gone up. And so we really want to thank God even for that. Grace and peace to you. Blessings, 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 blessings. Madam Secretary.
We'll prepare to give now as the ushers come, after which the next voice you'll hear is that of Pastor George Luby, and he'll be bringing the message this morning.
And remember, even in our giving, we are giving two offerings this morning. Amen. So we have our first tithes and offering, regular tithes and offering. Give generously. And Brother Devonta, while you're giving, I wanted to put up the other one. You know, we gave in special Easter offering to our WEF, our World Evangelism Fund. That will be the second offering, and we want you to even dig deeper. We are hoping today to raise some $3,000 for the world evangelism. And for those who are visiting, you might be wondering what's going on there. It's not staying here, but it is going to propagate the gospel. We have a lot of missionaries all around the world. We have hospitals, we have schools, we have all sort of different, compassionate ministries. And so the Church of the Nazarene worldwide, you know, every Easter we take up this special offering that will go to our general church, which is there in Kansas City, and all these different monies help to fund our missionaries and the different activities that we have going on over in the world. Some of us, we cannot go. Pray is enough. It's good to pray, but we want to able to send somebody. And so I'm asking you in a special way today to do something special. While you're giving your tithes and offering, that's for the local church. But that second offering, I really want the Lord to move upon you and you give something very special so that we can raise 3,000 EC dollars to send off to our World Evangelism Fund. God bless you and thank you.
Give you thanks for allowing us to be here one more time. We want to thank you for your goodness and your mercy towards us. Pray dear God, as we collect this morning tithes and offering, that you will bless it and use it for your honor and glory, we pray in Jesus' name.
When Mary came to find the tomb of Jesus, the stone was moved, the Lord had gone away. The angel said, fear not, the Lord is risen. Don't see the living here among the grave. He's gone. The stone is rolled back, gone. The tomb is empty. Gone to sit at the Father's side. He's gone over death, triumphant. He's gone. Sin is defeated. He's gone. He lives forevermore. If you believe that, give him a clap offering right there. Oh, come with me and see the risen Savior. Oh, he still can turn the dark of death to day. He can calm the storm of doubt and part the ocean. Oh, he still can roll your heavy storms away. Hallelujah, he's gone. The storm is rolled back, gone. The truth is empty. Forevermore. If you
Welcome to the Beacon Light Church of the Nazarene Family Worship Center.
Nazarene Missions is a movement of God through the people of God. This movement is funded through the generous, sacrificial giving of people and churches throughout the world. World evangelism giving is the foundation for discovering, developing, and resourcing our missions organization and has enabled the Church of the Nazarene to spread the good news of Jesus Christ to unreached people and places. It is the cornerstone of our denomination's missional funding, with the largest portion of giving going to missions work in the Nazarene regions. These funds enable the regions to effectively implement church planting and discipleship strategies through local churches and ministries. Every church and individual in our denomination participates with their financial contributions to world evangelism, binding us together with a unified purpose and vision. Because of your giving, the Church of the Nazarene is able to develop and sustain worldwide communication, technology support, and new mission programs. All Nazarene missionaries, regardless of deployment status, benefit from the Missions Foundation created by World Evangelism Giving. Each missionary receives support, such as funding, insurance, and missionary care. Nazarene Missions International, Nazarene Youth International, Work and Witness, Global Missions, and many other ministries are supported by World Evangelism Giving. Independently funded ministries like Nazarene Compassionate Ministries, Jesus Film Harvest Partners, and World Mission Broadcast also benefit from the infrastructure it sustains. Through your giving, new churches worldwide are able to make an impact in their community. Those funds also train and equip pastors and church leaders in these churches. Pastors like Rafi, who fulfilled his call to ministry after escaping war-torn Syria. Today, Rafi and his mother Lena have started two Arabic-speaking churches in Poland. Your giving funds clergy development and ordination in the Church of the Nazarene and makes holiness education available worldwide through Nazarene institutions of higher education. Your giving provides resources and literature in more than 90 languages to churches all over the world. This includes resources for pastors and Bible-based teaching materials for children, youth, and adults. Because of your giving, schools like the Armstrong Primary School in Côte d'Ivoire are impacting their community. School children are being taught Christian values, and the students and their families are being reached for the Lord. In Mark 12, we see the beautiful example of a widow giving abundantly. Jesus calls his disciples and points her out as the one who gave the most, because she gave all. Our focus is not on how much we give. We give because we believe in a missional God who is at work through our Nazarene missionaries, reaching places and people we can't even imagine. We believe in a God who moves. And that belief, deeply seated in our hearts, moves us to give. We are a global church, a generous church, participating in the transformational love of Jesus Christ in our local communities. Together, through our world evangelism giving, we share Christ's love with the world.
You just sit a while, because I'm going to invite you to stand again. Thank you. He's not here. Why he's not here? He has risen. Amen. He's gone. The grave is empty. Jesus has resurrected, as he said. Now I'm going to invite you to stand. We're going to read two portions of scripture. First, Matthew chapter 20. Shall we stand, please? Matthew chapter 20, verses 17 to 19. Matthew 20, 17 to 19. And Jesus, going up to Jerusalem, took the 12 disciples apart in the way and said unto them, Behold, we go up to Jerusalem, and the Son of Man shall be betrayed unto the chief priests and unto the scribes, and they shall condemn him to death, and shall deliver him to the Gentiles, to mock, to scourge, to crucify him. And the third day, he shall rise again. That's Jesus speaking there. Next portion, Matthew chapter 27. Matthew 27, from verse 35 to 47. Matthew 27. And they crucified him and parted his garments, casting lot that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by the prophet. They parted my garments among them, and upon my vesture did they cast lots. And sitting down, they watched him there, and set up over his head his accusation written, This is Jesus, the King of the Jews. Then were two thieves crucified with him, one on the right hand and the other on the left. And they that passed by reviled him, wagging their heads, and saying, Thou that destroyest the temple and buildest it in 3 days, save thyself. If thou be the Son of God, come down from the cross. Likewise also the chief priest mocking him with the scribes and the elders said, He saved others, himself he cannot save. If he be the King of Israel, let him now come down from the cross, and we will believe him. He trusted in God, let him deliver him now, if he will have him. For he said, I am the Son of God. The thieves also which crucified him cast the same in his teeth. Father, we thank you for your words. The entrance of your words bringeth light. Even the psalmist declared, Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Also says in your word, Thy word have I hid in my heart, that I might not sin against thee. As your words go forth today, O God, we know that your word is powerful and is sharper than any two-edged sword. Father, as your word go forth, we recognize human weakness. The word declares, it's not by might, neither is it by power, but by your spirit. Accomplish purpose today. You said your words will not return unto you void. Fulfill purpose, we pray, through your words. We give you the praise. We give you the thanks. In Jesus' precious name, amen. Thank you very much. May I have your seats. Now, Jesus says some things about himself. In Matthew 20, 17 to 19, verse 18, he says, He will be betrayed unto the chief priests and scribes. He says he will be condemned to death. He said he will be delivered to the Gentiles. He said he will be mocked. He said he will be scourged. He said he will be crucified. But then, on the third day, he shall rise again. Jesus was crucified. Yes, he was crucified. He was mocked. It's one of the things he said, that he will be mocked. Jesus, he was encouraged to come down from the cross. He was asked to come down from the cross. Scripture says, as they mocked him, says, likewise also the chief priests mocking him, and the scribes and elders say, he saved others, himself he cannot save. If he is the king of Israel, let him now come down from the cross, and we will believe him. He trusted in God. Let him deliver him now, if he will save him. For he said, I am the Son of God. Verse 42 of Matthew 27 says, he saved others. Himself he cannot save. Could Jesus have saved himself? Jesus declares in Matthew 28, verse 18, it says, all power is given unto me in heaven and on earth. Jesus was able to turn water into wine. Sure, some of us at some time or another, we would have drunk wine, not true? Grape wine, wine made from all kinds of fruits. But Jesus, he asked that some water pots be filled with water. And what happened? He turned that water into wine. Has any man done that yet? That's the power of Jesus. Jesus walked on water. You go down to the hotels, you see people on jet skis, and as you're walking on the water. Jesus was able to calm a storm. When the disciples were on the boat was rocking to and fro. They woke him up, and he got up. Peace be still. The wind and the waves obeyed him. Behold, what man of love, what power this man has, that even the wind and the waves obey him. Scripture tells us that Jesus, one of the young boys, young ones over there, young ones, look at me, look at me. What's that? Come, somebody shout out, what's that? Who said it over here? A cross. Jesus said he will be crucified. And what crucifixion means? To die on a cross. So they had him on the cross. There was a picture was here with three crosses. Three crosses standing side by side. Our broken Lord side. Two for their own transgressions died. The middle one for mine. The two thieves on either side of Jesus on the cross. Jesus was on the middle one. And one of them was mocking. Oh, you save others, save yourself. And the other one repented, eh? But tell me, they put Jesus on the cross. What kept him up there? The Bible tells us that they drove nails into his hands and into his feet. So the nails were holding him up there. But when the people were mocking him, it says, he saved others, himself he cannot save. If he be the King of Israel, let him come down from the cross and we will believe him. The question is, as powerful as Jesus is, could he have come down from the cross? Could he have come down? He has the power, man. He has the power. So let's face it. The nails that were driven into his hands and into his feet could not have held him there. It's not the nails that held him there. But what held him? What held him? You tie things with rope. The Bible didn't speak about any rope tying Jesus. Nails were driven into his hands and in his feet. Today we use rope to tie things. You think if they had the rope in that day, they could have kept him on the cross with a rope? No. You remember Samson? Samson, a man. When the Philistines were trying to get to know the source of his power, you remember they got him tied up a rope? And when he was so, Samson, the Philistines are upon you. Burst the rope. How about Jesus? Couldn't tie him there with a rope. But what it is that kept Jesus on the cross? What held him there? What held Jesus on the cross? Looking at a number of things that held him to the cross. Number one. What held him there? I have a student there getting into. Yes, what held him there? And the first thing I want to look at that held him there, it was love. Love. Love held him to that cross. It was his love for you and for me that held him there. He himself declared, greater love hath no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friend. It was his love for you and for me that held him to that cross. Jesus declares, the good shepherd giveth his life, what? For the sheep. Have you heard any shepherd to give life for sheep? Shepherd would go to the flock and take out the sheep. But Jesus, the Bible tells us, the good shepherd giveth his life for the sheep. John tells us, verse 3 and verse 16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. 2 Peter 3:9, God is not slack concerning his promise. He is not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. God commended his love towards us in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. 1 John 3:10 says, behold what manner of love the Father hath bestowed upon us, that we should be called the sons of God. What love! It's God's love for you and for me. Jesus went to that cross, died on the cross at Calvary. God should love a sinner such as I, should yearn to change my sorrow into bliss. No rest till he had planned to bring me nigh. How wonderful is love like this. Such love, such wondrous love, such love, such wondrous love, that God should love a sinner such as I. How wonderful is love like this. You know, Jesus knew he was going to die. He mentioned that. He was going to die and he was going to rise the third day. This same writer says that Christ should join so freely in the scheme, although it meant his death at Calvary. He joined in the scheme. He knew he was going to die. And he still agreed. That's love, not true? Love, that's love. And so it was. What held him? Not the nails. But what held him to that cross was love. 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 The second thing that held him to the cross obedience. Obedience. Obedience to God's will. Jesus says, for I am come down from heaven, not to do mine own will. That's John 6:38. For I am come down from heaven, not to do my own will, but the will of him that sent me. That's why I came, not to do my own will, but to do the will of him that sent me. And Jesus was obedient to the will of God. He was committed. I want us to look at something. John chapter 4. John chapter 4. Okay, 31 to 34. In the meanwhile, his disciples prayed, saying, Master, eat. But he said unto them, I have meat to eat that ye know not of. Yes. Verse 33. Therefore said his disciples, one to another, hath any man brought him aught to eat? Jesus replied, Jesus said unto them, my meat is to do the will of him that sent me and to finish the work. Here Jesus was with the woman of Samaria, spending some time there. If you look at verse 28, in John chapter 4, it tells us, the woman then left her water pot and went her way into the city and said to the men, come see a man which told me all things that ever I did. Is not this the Christ? The woman then left her water pot and went away into the city and said to them, come see a man which told me all things that ever I did. Is not this the Christ? And they went out of the city and came to him. In meanwhile, his disciples prayed, say, Master, eat. Spend a long time with this woman of Samaria. Must have been hungry, man. Must have been hungry. What did they say? Master, eat. Verse 32. But he said unto them, I have meat to eat, and ye know not of. Therefore said the disciples one to another, had any man brought him aught to eat? Jesus replied, Jesus said unto them, my meat is to do the will of him that sent me and to finish his work. He was committed. He was committed, and nothing was going to get into his way. He came to fulfill purpose. And even before the natural food, he said, look, my meat is to do the will of him that sent me and to finish the work. He was obedient, huh? Obedient to God's purpose, God's will. Obedience. He was obedient to the will of God. Sweet will of God, self hold me closer till I am wholly lost in thee. Sweet of God, self hold me closer till I am wholly lost in thee, sweet will of God. Self hold me closer till I am wholly lost in thee, sweet will of God. Self hold me closer till I am wholly lost in thee. Yes, the nails that were driven in his hands and in his feet could not have held him to that cross. But what held him? Love. What held him? Obedience. And the third thing that held him to that cross. Loyalty. Loyalty to God's purpose. Matthew 1 and 21 tells us Jesus was born. Matthew 1:21, what it says? And she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name what? Why? For he shall save his people from their sins. That's the name of Jesus. His name was called Jesus. For he shall do what? save his people from their sins. Scripture tells us, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. No matter how nicely dressed you look, no matter how good looking or handsome you are, or beautiful. Who sinned? All have sinned. All have sinned and come short of the glory of God. I think it's the psalmist David. I was born in sin and shaped in iniquity. But God, Scripture says the wages of sin is death, but what? The gift of God is eternal life. The gift of God is eternal life. And where can eternal life be found? In Jesus Christ. He says, I am come that they might have life. And have it how? More abundantly. Life is in Jesus Christ. Born in sin. Wages of sin is death. But you can have life today by accepting Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. The gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. It's a gift. You don't work for a gift. It's handed to you. And you can respond in two ways to a gift. Not true? You can either do what? Accept the gift, or you can what? Reject it. Salvation is being offered today, right now. If you know that you have not yet trusted Jesus Christ as your Savior, the Bible says, behold, now is the accepted time. Behold, now is the day of salvation. You know something, brethren? People are dying fast, you know. Ooh. And suddenly, too. Ooh. Behold, now is the accepted time. Don't know what's going to happen tomorrow, you know? No, but salvation is now. Are you willing to accept Jesus Christ now? Now is the day of salvation. You ready? Are you ready to accept Jesus? You're here. You know you're not saved. Are you ready to accept Jesus? No, not when you leave the building. Because the Bible says, behold, now is the accepted time. Behold, now is the day of salvation. Yes. Yes. You know, the focus today is on the resurrection of Jesus. But you know, he had to die first. No resurrection before his dying and his burial. Yes, 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 yes. But Jesus Christ, even though he knew that he was going to die, how he was going to save his people from their sins, he had to go to the cross at Calvary, not true? Death was a part of the plan. We looked at it already. One hymn writer says, oh, the love, the Jew salvation's plan. Oh, the grace that brought it down to man. Oh, the mighty gulf that God did span at Calvary. Jesus, he was committed. No wonder the hymn writer says, there is that green hill far away without a city wall, where the dear Lord was crucified, who died to save us all. We may not know, we cannot tell the pains he had to bear, but we believe it was for us. He hung and suffered there. Not true? Jesus didn't go on the cross to die for sins of his own. The sinless, spotless Lamb of God. So why was he on the cross? He was dying there for your sins and mine. On that green hill far away. You know why he had to die too? There was no other good enough to pay the price of sin. He only could unlock the gate of heaven and let us in. Nobody is good enough to die for our sins, because all of us in the same boat. All have sinned and come short of the glory of God. But it takes the sinless, spotless Lamb of God. It is John who says, behold the Lamb of God who taketh away the sins of the world. So today we are celebrating the resurrection of Jesus Christ. But first we have to look back. He died. He went on the cross. He went on the cross. And you know what happened? He died there. And you know something? This is what he says. No man taketh my life from me. I lay down that I might take it up again. That could not keep its prey. Jesus, my Savior, he tore the bars away. Jesus, my Lord, up from the grave, he arose. Up from the grave, he arose with a mighty triumph for his foes. He arose, victor from the dark. He arose. He arose. Yes, the nails that were driven into his hands and into his feet could not have held him to the cross. But what held him? Where's the students? Love. What else? Obedience. What else? Loyalty. Finally. Yes. Compassion. 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 In Matthew chapter 9, it says, verse 35, compassion. Matthew chapter 9, verse 35, it says, and Jesus went about all the cities and villages, teaching in the synagogues and preaching the gospel of the kingdom and healing every sickness and every disease among the people. Verse 36. And when he saw the multitudes, he was moved with compassion on them, because they fainted and were scattered abroad as sheep having no shepherd. But when he saw the multitude, what happened? He was moved with compassion. That's part of it. Compassion is compassion. Saw them as sheep without a shepherd. You know, the Bible tells us that this was compassion that caused Jesus to heal two blind men. Compassion. You know, before I came up here, the madam, she said, I'd like to get to my scriptures. Oh, dear. I like my scriptures. Let us go to, this is the last point. This is the last point. He moved with compassion. Okay? Matthew chapter 14 and verse 14. What it says. Yes, what it says there. And Jesus went forth and saw a great multitude and was moved with compassion towards them. And do what? Heal the sick. Again, compassion. 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 Mark chapter 1, verse 41. What it says here? And Jesus went forth. No, we're not there yet. Mark chapter 1, verse 41. You there now? No? Okay. Mark chapter 1, verse 41. And Jesus, moved with compassion, put forth his hand and touched him and said unto him, I will be thou clean. Jesus healed the leper. Verse 40 and 41 says, and there came a leper to him, beseeching him and kneeling down to him and saying unto him, if thou wilt, thou canst make me clean. And Jesus, moved with compassion, put forth his hand and touched him and said unto him, I will be thou clean. What moved him? Compassion. Compassion. Should we have that same compassion? As we seek the lost, eh? Should have the compassion that Jesus has, eh? Amen. 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 Look at another one, Luke chapter 7. Luke chapter 7. Luke chapter 7 from verse 11. Luke chapter 7, verse 11. What it says there? And it came to pass the day after that he went into a city called Nain, and many of his disciples went with him, and much people. Now when he came nigh to the gate of the city, behold, there was a dead man carried out, the only son of his mother, and she was a widow, and much of the people of the city was with her. Verse 13, it says, and when the Lord saw her, what happened? Oh my, there's our word again. When the Lord saw her, he was moved. He had what? Compassion on her. You know, when I think of the city of Nain, I think of my hometown, Five Island, that's why it's so small now, you know. Houses and so on all down Galley beside down there. But when I was a boy, a little small village. Everybody know everybody. Right? A small village. And you know, in that small community, you know, you have a kind of relationship, not true. Honestly, where what's happening here? When the people, the Bible tells us that now when he came nigh, it says, it was at this city called Nain. It says, and this, behold, there was a dead man carried out, the only son of his mother. And she was a widow, and much people of the city was with her. And when the Lord saw her, he had what? Compassion on her, and said unto her, weep not. This lady was in a bad state. What the Bible says? She was a widow. One minute, her husband died. And she has a son. I guess now he was old enough, and he was doing some work to keep them together. And then what happened? The son died. And I believe much of the people, they were with her. And so Jesus came and he saw what was happening. Can you imagine some people have their arms around her and saying things to her and so on. And Jesus was observing. Verse 13, and when the Lord saw her, he had compassion on her and said unto her, weep not. That verse 13. Well, you have a dead son and somebody going to tell you, weep not. But it wasn't an ordinary person who tells her to weep not. It was Jesus, the Son of God. Remember I said Jesus, Scripture says about Jesus in Matthew 28, 18, all power is given unto me in heaven and on earth. It was Jesus who spoke to Martha when Lazarus was dead. She said to Martha, Lazarus going to rise again. You're going to live. You're going to rise. So, yes, I know. Back in the, yes, of coming there. Hey, you gonna... No, Jesus said, no, no, no. Jesus says, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead. What happened? Yet shall he live. I tell you, Jesus is all powerful. He had death. He had power over death. And what happened to Lazarus? He said, show me where you are, I put bury him, buddy. He said, no, after 4 days now he buried him. After 4 days. What do you expect to find in a grave or a body that's dead for 4 days? What do you expect to find? Jesus said, show me where you are, I'll bury him. Oh, the resurrection of the powerful Jesus! What can wash away my sin? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. No matter how deep in sin you might appear to be, and how people might think you are, Jesus can wash you and make you clean. Amen? There is that fountain filled with blood, drawn from Emmanuel's veins, and sinners plunge beneath that flood, lose all their guilty stain. Jesus' blood was shed on Good Friday, not you? And that fountain is still flowing today. All you need to do is jump into that fountain and be washed and be cleansed from sin. So Jesus says, I am the resurrection and the life. He was able to bring back to life that boy. Verse 14 says, and he came and touched the bear, and they that bear him stood still. And he said, young man, I say unto thee, arise! Boss, what happened? And he that was dead sat up and began to speak, and he delivered him to his mother. I wonder what the people around there were saying. Ooh, that's a powerful, he's powerful. Look, I better get in touch with him. Yes, that's what I want you to know today. Jesus is powerful. And if you're not connected today, you can be connected today. Amen? Amen? He's all powerful. Nothing is too hard for him to do. Yes, Isaiah tells us that Jesus, he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. And what? By his stripes, we are healed. So what held Jesus at the cross? It wasn't the nails that was driven in his hands and into his feet. But what held him? Love, loyalty, obedience, and compassion. Does Jesus deserve a hand? Yeah. Yes. He bore it all for me. And the song we're singing, you know, sometimes I listen to song and sing them. Sometimes some words and a verse just pop out at me. And the song we were singing, death could not hold him down. You remember that, Sister Samuel? Death could not hold him down. That's Jesus. Yes, he himself declared, no man taketh my life from me. I lay it down that I might take it up again. You do not know Jesus Christ as Savior today. Jesus went to that cross and he bare your sins. Yes, nails were driven into his hands and into his feet. They mocked him. He saved others, but himself he cannot save. If he be the Son of God, come down from the cross. He could have done just that. But he came to fulfill purpose. It was for you and me why Jesus Christ died on the cross. So, as an unbeliever, you have not yet accepted Jesus Christ. Jesus has done all this for you. How are you going to respond? Jesus has done all this for you. You have not yet trusted Jesus. But he went to the cross and he died for your sins. What are you going to do about that? What are you going to do? How are you going to respond to that? You want me to help you? You have a choice. There's life and there's death. Eternal separation from God, death. But I encourage you to choose life. Amen? When you choose life, you choose Jesus. Not true? He came that we may have life, have it more abundantly. Anyone willing to take Jesus Christ as Savior on this Easter Sunday? Anyone? If you're here and just raise your right hand, you want to take Jesus. Behold, now is the accepted time. Behold, now is the day of salvation. Anyone? Yes. But for the Christian, for the believer, Jesus has done all this for us. How do we respond? How do we respond to this? How are we going to respond? On a hill far away stood an old rugged cross, the emblem of suffering and shame. And I love that old cross where the dead rest and best for a world of lost sinners was slain. So I cherish the old rugged cross till my soul fails at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. Shall we stand, please? The old rugged, to the old rugged cross I'll ever be true. Shall we stand? The old
rugged cross
I will ever be true. It's shame and reproach, gladly bear. Then he'll call me someday.
Then he'll call me someday.
To my home far away.
To my home far away.
Where his glory forever
where
I'll share.
His glory forever. I share,
so I cherish the old rugged cross until my trophy at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross as the saints someday for a crown. Amen. To that old rugged cross I will ever be true. Oh, yes, Lord. We're going to be true to the old rugged cross. Yes. Jesus Christ has died. And what is our response? That is free. Our precious Father and God who art in heaven, to you we live and move and have our being. Father, this morning throughout the Christian world, the resurrection of Jesus is being celebrated. But we know, Father, as we have been looking back, there can be no resurrection before his die and his burial, and then we have resurrection. And Father, we thank you that he himself declares, Jesus, I'm going to die, but on the third day, I'm going to rise again. And he did. Thank you, Lord. So one, no wonder we could join again with that hymn writer. Death could not keep its prey. Jesus, my Savior, he tore the bars away. Jesus, my Lord, up from the grave, he arose. Father, we thank you that salvation is in that name of Jesus. Oh God, the word declares, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Father, remember those who are in our midst today, have not yet trusted Jesus Christ as Lord and as Savior. Father, I pray, oh God, before it's too late, even today, or even before they leave this building, that they'll turn their lives over to Jesus, inviting him into their hearts and into their lives, confessing their sin. Jesus, I have sinned, but you died for my sin. I now accept you as my Lord and as my Savior. Oh God, for those who have trusted Jesus and are going on in the faith, join with that hymn writer. I will cling to the old rugged cross. Someday I'll exchange it for a cross. To that old rugged cross, I'll be true. Oh God, help us to be true as believers in Christ. We know that we have our challenges because your word declares that Satan is like a roaring lion seeking whom he may devour. But we are glad, as your word declares, greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. Thank you for everyone present today. Father, I ask your blessing upon each one. Oh Lord, you're able to meet every need. The Apostle Paul says, my God shall supply all you need. Meet needs today. There might be that one who needs salvation, and that's the cry of our hearts. And turn to Jesus, whom to know right is life eternal. To those who have financial need, economic needs, oh God. God who can meet all needs. Meet needs, we pray. Solve problems. Move from heart to heart. Bless. Meet the needs of the people, Lord. Each one. In the name of Jesus Christ. And so, Father, we thank you. Thank you for Jesus. For his willingness to come into the world. As we looked at, nails did not hold into that cross. But it was love. Yes, Lord. It was obedience. It was loyalty. It was compassion. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you. Let us give the Lord some praise. God is behind everything. The name of the Lord. God bless every one of you. We have your seats.
Thank you very much, Reverend Luby. Put your hands together for Reverend Luby. Thank you very much for the word. And it wasn't the cross. It wasn't the stripes. But we know it wasn't the nail. But it was love, obedience, loyalty, and compassion. We thank God for his word. And so even as we leave today, it was a little extra time, but we can't do much, too much for God. Amen. Amen. And we have a whole evening and a whole tomorrow to rest. So we're not going to work tomorrow, but we're leaving now. We want to continue to remember even our dear sister Yvette Brown. Remember our shut-in. Remember Sister Yvette Brown. You know, she's not keeping too well, and so we want you to be much in prayer. And those who can visit, you know, she's at the Tabitha home there, up there in Upper Gambles, I believe that's the area you call there. And let us remember our shut-ins. I am seeing some, you know, do we have any visitors? I'm seeing a gentleman, I'm not familiar with him at all, sitting next to Sister Doline. I don't know if it's the first time you're coming, sir. The first time you're coming? Oh, not the first. I'm not. That's your uncle? That's your uncle there? Okay, right. That's your uncle, right? Okay, All right. So he's so happy to have you, sir. All right. God bless you. Nice to have you. Thank you very much. Put hands together for him. Do we have any other visitors? I know that some would have left earlier on. Oh, I'm seeing my good friend behind there. What's her name again? My mommy. Oh, Lord, even after she gets married and so the mommy not leaving her side. Father, we pray for her husband, for the mommy, in Jesus' name. Amen. Glory. I'm not behaving myself. What's your name again? Right there. Yes, yes, you. We're so happy to have you. We're so happy to have you. God bless you and your friend there. And oh, all the others, we are so happy to have. Oh, yes, that's a visitor as well. All right. On vacation. All right. And if Sharon left already, oh, we're so happy those people come in on vacation and they still find themselves in the house of the Lord. Anybody else? Anybody else? That lady in the African nice outfit there. The first time you come in? Return. Oh, come on, the church. Make some noise. Returning visitors. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Man, we're catching up under the woman so far. Wait until you reach home for that, please. All right. God bless you. So nice to have all of you. And tomorrow, God's willing. Tomorrow. And oh, Engineer Alien. The Engineer's, yeah, that's your, oh, that's your parents, glory to God. I have plenty complaints to make, so don't leave. Oh, we're so happy to have Sophia and Angel's parents, so nice to have you. And I thought I saw your brother earlier on, no? He was here? Huh? Okay, right, God bless you. So nice, put your hands together for them, so nice to have you. Blessings, blessings, blessings. Oh my God, we're going home now. Leave me alone. We're going home now. But my heart is strangely warm. My heart is strangely warm. I'm looking at the back and I'm seeing all of the pain sisters, almost all, less one. And so I don't know about you, but I'm all excited. Oh, I'm missing Molly. Oh, Kiara, stand up. I haven't seen you for a long time. Just stand up. Let me see how you look. Yes, just stand up. Yes, 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 yes. Oh, my God. Yes, yes. These are all our girls. Oh, and mommy sit down there like a peahen. Oh, so she's not spreading wings. All right. So it's so nice. It's a joy. It's really a joy to have all of you in the house of the Lord today. Tomorrow, God willing, we're going to join with the zone. Some of our church is going to come together at Fry's Beach. Yes. And so we want to invite as many of you to come and be part of the zone celebration. When last you met your brothers, your brothers and sisters from Living Water, it has been a long time. Eh? And so we want to invite you to come out. And we, you know, you're coming and we are asking you to come and don't bring food alone just for yourself, right? Because most likely the pastor coming with his tulang empty hand, and he's expecting to eat. Amen, somebody. And so we want all of you to come, bring something, bring some drinks, bring... Oh, okay, Sister Yvette says that she's going to feed the pastor. Hallelujah, glory to God. And so all the others, so come, let us celebrate, let us spend the time. Normally we'll go by ourselves, but normally... But this time we're going to join our sister churches, and that will be at Fry's. We're going to be there from 9 o'clock, and so we're expecting to all of you to come, bring your season rice. You know, and it's only one season rice. There is no other season rice. If you bring any rice without the seasoning, that is not season rice. And bring your what the fish name? What the fish name now? Where the fish name? Escovitch fish and all them kind of thing. And we will eat and drink and be merry, and we're going to swim. And I know Brother Tish bring in some drinks and all this sort of thing there. Oh, Lord of mercy. God have mercy upon me. All right? And so we want to celebrate tomorrow. So God bless you. Hope that you enjoy the rest of your day. And one other thing, Wednesday is our first Wednesday. And we're going to be praying from 6 to 6. You'll get some more information. But one of the things I feel led to do is that at lunchtime, I want you to hear me. At lunchtime, we're going to open the Zoom room. That's on Wednesday at lunchtime. So we're going to pray our regular prayer meetings here in the church and on Zoom. But at midday, 12 o'clock on the dot, the Zoom room will be open. And we want to invite you, once you're not too busy, You know, if you take your lunch, it's not going to be for a whole hour, just about half an hour, and we're going to come together and we're going to pray. We're going to pray for everything concerning the church. We're praying for the pastor, we're praying for the church board, we're praying for the department leaders and their councils, and we're just praying for everything concerns the church, and so concerning the church. And so at midday, I hope you so send that out, invite somebody at midday. You know, we can't come together because of our location and situation, but we're going to be coming together and Zoom at midday for about half an hour as we continue to lift up the name of Jesus. Amen? And so may God's richest blessings continue to be with you. Let us stand at this time. Oh, and we want to celebrate. We celebrate in our Malik. Glory to God. We pray God's richest blessing. And I hope that we're not just celebrating him, but we're praying for him. You know, we are praying for him. We are praying for him because sometimes even as these things start to happen, they're exposed to so many different things. And sometimes they turn their back upon God. But for now, we are so excited about our own Malik breaking record, you know. And so we give God thanks and praise. We remember the parents. The mom is not here. She went to bury her dad in Dominica last Wednesday. Let's continue to pray for the family. And I'm sure that as we do, great and mighty things will be wrought. Amen? 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 And so may the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God, the rich fellowship of the Holy Spirit, rest and abide with us now and forevermore. Amen. Greet somebody and have a wonderful Easter weekend.